we are talking to the Bellator welterweight champ of the world, also a Bellator Grand Prix champ. Two different things there. He won a tournament and I guess one of the latest millionaires in the United States. How you doing, Chase?
I'm doing good, man. You know, same old, trying to train as much as I can with this crazy times, but you know, it's going good.
Douglas, we ask the PFL fighters this question all the time. What was that like waiting for that $1 million wire to come through? I mean, I know it's a fact, but you kind of wake up and check your banking account every day? Definitely.
Well, it was actually a hold for like two or three weeks. You know what I mean? Got me a little nervous. But no, it hit the account, man. I was happy. I was checking it every day, you know. But yeah, it was good. Nervous at first, but it happened, so it was good.
Did you already do your taxes for 2020? I mean, did you get to keep most of it?
I'm definitely not keeping most of it, but no, I didn't do it yet. I'm actually talking to the accountant now as we speak. Yeah, I'm not looking forward to that. You know what I mean? I already separated, you know, kind of the amount, you know, but yeah, it's tough. It's rough. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and something like that, maybe you can peel back the curtain a little bit, but I imagine this was all 50 Cent, right? Was it 50 Cent and Bellator, or did this really come directly from 50 Cent?
I have no idea. Actually, Bellator is who wrote the checks. You know, they really said that 50 Cent paid it. You know what I mean? But the check came from the same company. You know, Bellator wrote it for me. You know what I mean? I guess they had insurance or something. You know, if something happened where he wouldn't pay, you know, I think Bellator would take care of it. Mm-hmm. You know, it was the same check from them that I always get.
Now, last week we heard that Bellator, you know, they're starting to spread their wings a little bit. They're going to CBS Network, Sports Network, excuse me. They're talking about potentially maybe CBS and Showtime. And with all that, we heard the announcement of Bellator recharged on Saturday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern with a replay on Wednesday. So I looked to see what fighters were there, and you were one of the ones featured. Unfortunately, is when you lost to Roy, but oh, look at the record. I see you've made up a lot. You've won a lot of your rematches, you know, and right now you're the prettiest champ. But can you talk about that night and what did that night do for you to propel you to all of a sudden win three in a row? But basically, the three most important fights of your life. You won the title, you won the Grand Prix title, and you made a lot of money.
Yeah. Man, that fight, I'm so thankful for that fight. You know, it's fine. I'll be okay if they keep showing that fight. It's still even though I lost, you know, it was still a better fight than the second one. You know what I mean? I think fans will enjoy that one a lot more. You know, and I actually got a lot of good, you know, reviews, you know, a lot of good comments from that fight as well, because many people thought I won. You know what I mean? You know, of course, I lost the decision. You know what I mean? Got taken down a lot, but the damage, you know, favored me that fight. So a lot of fans really thought I won that fight. But the main thing I take from it is just, I don't know, I just learned so much from that experience. You know what I mean? Just being able to, you know, like I look at Rory, being able to push the way he did on that last round after being so badly injured. You know, I really learned a lot from that. You know what I mean? It's like fight no matter what. You know, it doesn't matter if you're tired, if you're hurt, you still got to fight. And that's what I learned from him from that fight. You know what I mean? Because, man, I used to get taken down a lot in fights, and most of it, you know what I mean, not taking anything away from any fighters, but most of it is because I got lazy. You know what I mean? Most of the time I was scared of getting tired, and I wouldn't fight as hard to defend the takedowns. You know what I mean? So definitely changed that on my game after that fight. You know, the second time, the fight after that was against Koreshkov, and I put it on my head. I was like, dude, I'm not getting taken down one time. You know what I mean? I'm going to fight as hard as I can to defend. And it worked, you know what I mean? So it was more of a mental thing that I really fixed after that fight. You know, it was just go no matter what. It doesn't matter if you're tired. You know, if I'm tired, the other guy's fighting as well. It's tired as well. So you just got to go. And that's what I learned from him. You know what I mean? I think it's got to be good for my career, you know, until I'm retired. You know what I mean? Definitely a lesson learned in that fight.
Douglas, it seems like there's a lot of lessons that you've learned here as of late. And having the streak, now with MMA kind of paused and us not really being too sure when exactly you're going to step back foot in the cage, when you do you feel like you can still carry the momentum from the previous matchups, or did too much time pass in between?
For sure, for sure. You know, the time is going, you know, it's going crazy, but I'm still training. You know, I got my coaches, you know, I don't have as many training partners, but, you know, three or four good training partners I always have. You know what I mean? My coach is always here. You know, I got my own gym so I can open it, you know, as much as I can. You know, there wasn't a lot of people. It's just us. So, you know, I'm keeping it safe. You know, I'm keeping the distance. But, man, I'm not going to stop training. You know, it's my job. I'm very fortunate that I have a place to do it. You know what I mean? It's just me and my coach sometimes. Most of the times, you know, I still work on the little details and, you know, stuff like that, hitting pads a lot. You know, like conditioning, weight training. I'm doing it all, you know what I mean? Because definitely I don't want to lose that momentum, and I don't want to be too out of shape, you know what I mean? So when I come back, you know, it's going to take, you know, 8 weeks, 10 weeks to get back in shape. So I'm doing what I can, you know, at least once a day, five times a week I train, you know what I mean? So definitely got to keep the momentum going. You know, I feel really good, man. I feel healthy, you know, I'm in a great, you know, chapter of my career right now. And I got to keep this going. You know what I mean? They say when you hit 32, 33 years old, that's when you really hit your prime. And I'm kind of feeling it right now. You know what I mean? I feel good. I feel healthy. And, you know, as soon as this stuff is over with, be back in the cage, you know, doing what I did.
You know, a lot of fighters talk about their routines. They like routines. They like things to stay the same. Mm-hmm. When you step back in the cage, things are going to be a little different. Have you thought about that whole process of how that's going to play out? Even just walking through the curtain and there not being any fans.
Mm-hmm.
Psychologically, is there anything you can do to think about that, to help you with that?
I think that would be even easier for me because I feel like most of the pressure, you know, the jitter is not going to be there. You know, if I fight, for example, in a place where there's no crowd, you know, because, man, when you're walking out and you see, you know, 10,000, 15,000 people around you, they scream you, I get a little, you know, I get the jitters looking at that, you know what I mean, feeling that it's a great energy, but at the same time, I'm like, man, a lot of people watching, you know what I mean, I can't perform bad, so that's another thing that's going to be out of the way, you know, if I fight in a place that there's no fans, you know. But for me, like, when I step inside the cage, it's the same. You know, it doesn't matter where the cage is. It can be in the middle of the sea where it's just water around us, you know. If it's just a cage and the guy's there in front of me, I'm going to perform. You know what I mean? As long as I'm ready, you know, if I'm training, I'm healthy, and they give me an opponent, you know, I'll be ready to go. I don't think, you know, none of this stuff that happens, you know what I mean? Of course, you know, it's devastating for a lot of people losing their lives and stuff. But, you know, thank God everything is, you know, it's working good for me. You know, my family are safe. You know, I'm doing my part. But, man, I can't wait to get back in the cage. You know, I want to get this going. You know, I'm very excited, you know, to fight again, especially for another belt. I was very excited for this fight. But the momentum is still there, you know. I'm still working. You know, I'm still doing what I can. And just can't wait to perform again.
You mentioned your gym earlier. If I'm not mistaken, you and your brothers own a gym in Georgia, the state of Georgia, right?
Yes, sir. Georgia. I just opened my own, you know, me and my brother. You know, it's an American top team affiliate, you know, Team Lima.
Yeah.
You know, haven't opened yet. Everything is ready. You know, we got everything done, you know, at these crazy times. But we can't open it yet. You know, I think we can for the – maybe for the cardio kickboxing, you know, the CrossFit side. But I don't know, man. I don't know. We're looking at the laws, you know, seeing what everything we can do.
Douglas, we were talking about the state that you live in. Georgia is one of the first to open back up. The governor has stated, you know, there's businesses like, you mentioned, he's like nail salons and tattoo parlors and other types of businesses aside from essential are opening up. So Where do you sit? Because you've expressed during this interview, you know, a little bit of anxiety and nervousness as to how you're going to, like, maybe separate people, but at the same time, it's business, you know what I mean? So how are you balancing that?
Yeah, I mean, the good thing for us is that we are a new business, you know, we don't even have all the members signed up yet, you know what I mean? So we're actually at a good place, you know, because we're just getting started. So I don't know, we're still looking at all the laws and everything that we can do right now. You know what I mean? We're thinking of opening, but at the same time, you know, there's a lot of people that's against it. You know what I mean? So it's a situation that we got to deal with. You know, I can't do any jiu-jitsu classes or Muay Thai, but the cardio kickboxing, I think we can't do because we can't keep them separated. You know, they're using the punching bag you know, not working with each other. So I think that one could be easier in the CrossFit side as well. So I don't know. We're still thinking about it. We haven't opened yet. Maybe, you know, by next week, you know, I just want to open when everything is a little more, you know, safer for everybody, you know, because last thing I want is, you know, it's a case that happens in the gym. So, you know, we got to be really safe and take all the precautions and stuff like that. And let's see what happens. Maybe next week we'll be able to open.